Thanks, guys, for joining me again. Part 3, Hotel California. Mark Redmayne here with my guitar lesson. We did part 1 with the chords, part 2 with the intermediate leads, and now part 3 is the full end lead solo of Hotel California. So I hope you enjoy it. Let's jump right in. This starts from the A note, slides up to the G flat. Then hits an A and a B, overtones the B, then goes from A to B to E. Then a D, E, F sharp, D, a B flat, a little trill off the B to the C sharp. And that gets us to the end of part one. So let's have a listen to part one again. Part two. Little D, E, F sharp, D, B, A, B. So. Does it twice. Then kick back off the A to the G. Then bend up with a little country bend from the A to the B, hit the D note on the bottom string. See, it hits back on the A, then comes off to the G. So let's have a look at part two. So. Now, come up onto the part three here on this 12th fret. So we're going to B, a G, and a D, bend up to the E. Back to the B note. So have a listen again. Then get the A, bend it up, hit the D note. Back to the G. So let's have a listen to that again. Now hit the E note, bend it up to the F sharp, and hit the B note on the bottom string of the E string. So I'm on the G string there. So it's a bending up the E, back from the F sharp to the E, back to the D. Then a little trill from D, D flat, D. Then we've got a little kick up here. It's F sharp, D, E, F sharp. And then a little bluesy, Chuck Berry type of bend here, where you're bending the E, hitting the F sharp and the B on the bottom. That's the D note. Okay, so that's the end of that part. Then it changes the sound where another guitar player, Joe Walsh, or I think jumps in or something there and starts over for his part of the solo. The guitars are sort of changing parts through the part. That's where the changeover ride sits. So let's have a look at that part three. Now the next part comes in part four, another guitar player. Different type of tone in that way. So let's have a look at the next part of the solo. The same little trill. Keeps going a bit longer. Then get the G note, bend it up the A. Then trill it off and hit the E. Rest on the B note. Have a listen to it? E note, B note. Now, go down to the A. We're going to hit the A, bend up. As it approaches the B, hit the B on the bottom. That's like that little... the, that sort of... A, G, slide up to the B, hit the D. Then walk back down semitone by this. This increments down, so we're going B, B flat, A, A flat. So let's have a listen to that part there. This is the fourth part. Now we come back up here. We're going to hit the A note here. So we're going all the way up there. A, B, D, E. Back to the D. Then bend up the E to the F sharp, hit the B note, sorry, the A note underneath there. So have a listen to that little section. That's a E, F sharp, G, A, G sharp, A, right up to the A. Then the E bent to the D note. Have a listen to that part again. Okay, now, once we get to there, we've got a little low. So you hit the bottom note twice. So it's like you're staying around that signal. There's only three odd four notes in there. So you're bending it. So you're bending that E up to the F sharp. Back to that D note. Do it again. And that's the A note bent to the B. So let's have a listen to that whole section. Another guitar player jumps in, and it goes back to that bluesy thing. So that's the changeover. Okay, so you got that section. Then he jumps right up to this E note, where he bends it up and then retards it and slows it down. So he retards the tempo as it sinks back down again. We've all heard that type of thing on the guitar before. Now we've got this little run. That's a B and an A. A D to a C sharp, and that's a little like a little passing note step down. That's an F sharp, an F, an E, A, and a D. Have a listen again. Okay, now down to here, and we've got this section here to do. So we come onto this part here. We go. It's like two notes, but not a double stop, but played separately as a melodic. So you play the A and the D. Sink down to the, so we keep the A, sink down to the C sharp. Down to the G and the B. Up to the G flat and the A. Down to the E and the G. And end on the D, which is a D ender. F sharp. So it sort of starts there and ends there. So let's have a listen to it. Okay, now we've got a little, we sort of like, we've got to run down from there. So let me put that in context to it. First string to the third string. Now, let's have a listen to that again, that section. Thingy. Kick straight on from the D to the A to the E and the G. So D, F sharp to the E and the G. Then slide up to the G flat and the A. B and G. Sink it down a semitone. Same notes here. B flat and the G flat. Back up to the B and the G. Back up to C sharp and A. And then we're onto that iconic end, and we'll talk about that in a second. So let's have a look at that whole section again. Okay, here we go, on the end. Now, the next part of this is a chord. So if you play this little triad here, so on the 14th fret, we've got an F sharp, a D, and a B. Well, that makes up a triad. If we slide that down an octave and then put a couple more notes with it, what have you got? The B minor chord. The B minor chord. So these all follow chords, so I'll talk through them as we go. Firstly, a B minor triad. So you go. F sharp triad. There's the F sharp. Up to the third note of the F sharps of the F sharp here, the third, which is a B flat. I'm hitting a B flat there. So let's try that part. Okay. Now drop down. Remember, the next chord is a G. An A chord is the next chord. So we go B flat, a B minor to F sharp major to an A. Well, here's the A here. Look, try an A. So an E, C sharp, and an A. So we put just a little triad on there, and we play it backwards. And next chord, E. And there's the third of the E, which is, of course, the G sharp or A flat. Then come back down, next chord is a G. Here's the triad of the G. And next chord is a D, and there's the D. And there's the third triad there, on, of course, the F sharp. Then up to the E minor, which is a little triad here, straight across from G, B, and E. And F sharp, again. B flat. So have a listen to that last section. That's the end of the solo. So let me just play it once through you, right to that section. Remember, it does that twice at the end. It rolls across that and fades out. So you can do whatever you want with that end of the song from there. Okay. End on a B, nice big B, or nice casual B minor, or even a high octave. So note, whatever you'd like to put as caption. Let's play through the solo. Let me just slowly go through it, but add a little bit more pace and smoothly. Thank you. So, twice through that end part, the solo is yours. Thanks very much. I'll see you on my next lessons. I got heaps of things I'd love to show you, and I hope you enjoy learning from me. I'm Mark Redmayne out, and see you next time. Bye.